Gildan Media presents Your Coach in a Box, affordable, life-changing audio programs.
Worldwide Rave, creating triggers that get millions of people to spread your ideas and share your stories. Written by David Meerman Scott. Read by Walter Dixon. This one is for my brothers, Alan and Peter. You and I are incredibly lucky. We're living in a time when we can reach the world directly without having to spend enormous amounts of money on advertising and without investing in huge public relations efforts to convince the media to write or broadcast about our products and services. There is a tremendous opportunity right now to reach buyers in a better way by publishing great content online. Content people want to consume and that they are eager to share with their friends, family, and colleagues. One of the coolest phenomena on the web is that when an idea takes off, it can propel a brand or company to seemingly instant fame and fortune for free. Creating a worldwide rave in which other people help to tell your story for you is a way to drive action. One person sends it to another. Then that person sends it to yet another, and on and on. Each link in the chain exposes your story to someone new, someone you never had to contact yourself. It's like when you're at a sporting event or concert in a large stadium and somebody starts the wave. Isn't it amazing that just one person with an idea can convince a group of 50,000 people to join in? Well, you can start a similar wave of interest online, a worldwide rave. You can create the triggers that get millions of people to tell your stories and spread your ideas. The worldwide rave is one of the most exciting and powerful ways to reach your audience. Anyone with thoughtful ideas to share and clever ways to create interest in them can become famous and find success on the web. The challenge for marketers is to harness the amazing power of the worldwide rave. The process is actually quite simple. Anyone can do it, including you. However, if you're already an experienced marketer, you need to know that success requires a far different approach than what you're likely doing now. Many of the easy techniques for triggering a worldwide rave are the exact opposite of what you've learned on the job or have been taught in school. Similarly, if you're a CEO, business owner, or entrepreneur, you should know that these ideas are likely precisely what your agency partners and marketing staff tell you not to do. If you've already had some success getting your stories and ideas to spread online, great. Those experienced with online media will benefit from the wealth of new ideas and fascinating stories of success I share in this audio program. There are some very surprising approaches here, and I believe even experts will learn a great deal. So, without further ado, let's look at the important components for generating a worldwide rave of your own. As you hear these next few minutes, consider how completely different these ideas are from what you're likely doing today. Rules of the rave. Of course, it's obvious as hell that in order for thousands or even millions of people to share your ideas and stories on the web, you must make something worth sharing. But how do you do that? Here are the essential components. This list is so important, and each item such a strong predictor of success, that I call them your rules of the rave. I introduce the 6 rules here and then provide much more detail later, elaborating on each one in its own section of the audio program. Nobody cares about your products, except you. Yes, you heard that right. What people do care about are themselves and ways to solve their problems. People also like to be entertained and to share in something remarkable. In order to have people talk about you and your ideas, you must resist the urge to hype your products and services. Create something interesting that will be talked about online. But don't worry, because when you're famous on the web, people will line up to learn more and to buy what you offer. No coercion required. For decades, organizations of all kinds have spent bucketfuls of money on advertising designed to coerce people into buying products. Free shipping. This week only, 20% off. New and improved. Faster than the other guys. this product-centric advertising is not how you get people talking about you. When you've got something worth sharing, people will share it. No coercion required. Lose control. Here's a component that scares most people silly. You've got to lose control of your messages. You need to make your valuable online content totally free and freely shareable, and you must understand that a worldwide rave is not about generating sales leads. Yes, you can measure success, but not through business school return on investment ROI calculators. Put down roots. When I was a kid, my grandmother said, "If you want to receive a letter, you need to send a letter to someone first." Then when I was in college, my buddy said, "If you want to meet girls, you have to go where the girls are." The same thing is true in the virtual world of the web. If you want your ideas to spread, you need to be involved in the online communities of people who actively share. Create triggers that encourage people to share. When a product or service solves someone's problem or is very valuable, interesting, funny, or just plain outrageous, it's ready to be shared. To elevate your online content to the status of a worldwide rave, you need a trigger to get people talking. Point the world to your virtual doorstep. If you follow the rules of the rave, as I've described them, people will talk about you. And when they do, they'll generate all sorts of online buzz that will be indexed by the search engines, all relating to what your organization is up to. Forget about data-driven search engine technologies. The better approach to drive people to your stuff via the search engines is to create a worldwide rave. As a result, your organization's websites will quickly rise to prominence in the rankings on Google, Yahoo, and the other search engines. That's it. Simple, right? Sure, generating a worldwide rave is as simple as can be. But again, when I discuss these ideas, I find that they are so foreign to many people's thinking that they need much more than a list of rules in order to pull it off naturally. So, the remainder of this audiobook will be organized around these rules of the rave so that you can learn them too. My challenge to you is to implement them and create a worldwide rave of your own. Telling stories. I often use the word stories when I talk about the content people want to share. I do that on purpose. People love to share stories. When someone says, "Let me tell you a story," you're interested, right? When someone says, "Let me tell you about my company's product," is your reaction the same? It doesn't sound like a way you want to spend your valuable time, does it? Stories are exciting. Most business writing is dry. That's why I've loaded this audio program with 39 stories, most told directly by folks who created worldwide raves. There will be how-to information too, of course. But the reason I'm including so many stories in this audiobook is that the fascinating people profiled here can explain, in their own words, their strategies for triggering a worldwide rave much better than I can do with too many flowcharts, four square diagrams, and to-do checklists. Stories sell. So let's get moving. We'll start with one of my favorite stories about a worldwide rave. When 7 equals 350 million. Imagine you're the head of marketing at a theme park and you're charged with announcing a major new attraction. What would you do? Well, the old rules of marketing suggest that you pull out your wallet. You'd probably spend millions to buy your way into people's minds, interrupting them with TV spots, billboards by the side of the highway, and other creative Madison Avenue advertising techniques. You'd also hire a big PR agency who would beg the media to write about your attraction. The traditional PR approach requires a self-congratulatory press release replete with company muckety-mucks claiming that the new attraction will bring about world peace by bringing families closer together. That's not what Cindy Gordon, Vice President of New Media and Marketing Partnerships at Universal Orlando Resort, did when she launched the Wizarding World of Harry Potter. Other large entertainment companies would have spent millions of dollars to interrupt everyone in the country with old rules approaches, Super Bowl TV ads, blimps, direct mail, and magazine ads. Instead, Gordon just told 7 people about the new attraction. And those 7 people told tens of thousands. Then, mainstream media listened to those tens of thousands and wrote about the news in their newspaper and magazine articles, in TV and radio reports, and in blog posts. Gordon estimates that 350 million people around the world heard the news that Universal Orlando Resort was creating the Wizarding World of Harry Potter theme park, all by telling just 7 people. Tapping the enthusiasm of millions of fans. Recognizing that millions of people around the world are passionate about all things Harry Potter, Gordon knew she could rely on a worldwide rave to spread her story. After all, Harry is a global phenomenon. The series of books by author J.K. Rowling has been translated into 65 languages and has sold more than 325 million copies in more than 200 territories around the world. The films, produced by Warner Brothers Pictures, have grossed $3.5 billion worldwide at the box office alone. Gordon and her counterpart at Warner Brothers chose to launch the Wizarding World of Harry Potter by first telling the exciting news to a very small group of rabid fans. 7 people at the top Harry Potter fan sites, such as MuggleNet, were hand-selected by Gordon's team with Warner Brothers and Rowling herself providing input about the choices. These 7, affectionately referred to by Gordon's team as the AP of the HP world, were invited to participate in a top-secret webcast held at midnight on May 31, 2007. The webcast was hosted by Scott Trowbridge, Vice President of Universal Creative, and featured Stuart Craig, the Academy Award-winning production designer for all the Harry Potter films. In the webcast, live from the Dumbledore's Office set at Leavesden Studios, Craig discussed how his team of 20 designers is bringing together the Wizarding World of Harry Potter theme park. "If we hadn't gone to fans first, there could have been a backlash," Gordon says. She imagined the disappointment dedicated Harry Potter fans might feel if they learned about Universal Orlando's plans in, say, the New York Times, rather than an insider fan site. Soon after the webcast, the team sent an e-announcement to their in-house, opt-in email list of park guests so these consumers could hear the news directly, too. Team members also sent the e-announcement to friends and family. During the secret webcast, a web microsite went live to provide a place for bloggers and the media to link to for information on the theme park, which is slated to open in late 2009 or early 2010. Visitors to the site learned that the park will feature immersive rides and interactive attractions, as well as experiential shops and restaurants that will enable guests to sample fare from the Wizarding World's best-known establishments. Because Gordon's team launched the Wizarding World of Harry Potter through social media, putting fans first, they were able to run the entire promotion in-house with a very small marketing budget, covering the webcast infrastructure and the microsite production, and a tiny development team. They did not hire an agency, and they did no widespread outbound media relations, no marketing stunts, no CEO conference call, and no expensive advertising. Of course, not all companies have Harry Potter on their team, but Gordon still accomplished a remarkable feat with an approach that most large organizations would not have taken. She told just 7 people, and the power of the worldwide rave she created led to 350 million people hearing the news. Advice for generating a worldwide rave from Cindy Gordon, Vice President of New Media and Marketing Partnerships, Universal Orlando Resort. Nimble companies are using the web in ways that they could never do before. New media has created a new marketing environment where the old rules of marketing no longer apply. When you have a passionate fan base for your brand, the internet is especially vital. Communicating to a small but powerful group of fans first online to enlist their support is a smart way to ensure positive coverage in the mainstream press. The power of the internet makes it easier for people to fall in love with you faster. But beware, it also makes it easier for them to fall out of love with you faster. It's a double-edged sword. Listen constantly to what's being said about you. Social media technologies do not make a brand viral. They merely allow consumers to tell others about good brands. The main thing is to be different and relevant with your brand. And when you have that, the sheer power of the internet can accelerate your brand. Traditional media takes weeks to build brand awareness and months to build preference. The internet can make your brand famous literally overnight. The Worldwide Rave empowers you. The Worldwide Rave is the single most empowering tool available to marketers today. As you will learn, the formula for success includes a combination of some great and free web content, a video, blog entry, interactive tool, or ebook that provides valuable information, or is groundbreaking, or amazing, or hilarious, or involves a celebrity, plus a network of people to light the fire and links that make your content very easy to share. I wrote this audio program so you, too, can take advantage of the power of spreading ideas. These are the new rules that thousands of people have used to sell billions of dollars worth of products and services worldwide. Success comes from self-publishing web content that people want to share. It's not about gimmicks. It's not about paying an agency to interrupt others. It's about harnessing the Worldwide Rave, the most powerful form of marketing there is. Cindy Gordon of Universal Orlando Resort launched The Wizarding World of Harry Potter by publishing a microsite and a webcast. That's it. Using an idea-spreading strategy, she reached 350 million people with two pieces of internally created web content. You can achieve similar success, and I'll show you how. You must ignore the old rules of advertising and PR. It's worth saying one more time. A Worldwide Rave is not about interruption. It's not about coercion, and it's not about buying access. Don't get sucked into gimmicks. In the old days, you either had to buy expensive advertising or beg the media to tell your story. Sadly, many organizations don't realize that they have a much better option. They can tell their story directly to an interested market. The best Worldwide Raves promote your organization and its products and services by delivering great online content tied directly to your products, services, and ideas. That's tied to, not touting. Success comes from the fact that people want to share this content with their friends, colleagues, and family members. Since this isn't the same old advertising and PR that you and your agencies have been practicing for years, you'll need to throw out some old ideas and pick up some new ones. Don't obsess about being on message. Don't beg mainstream media to write about you. Don't break the bank with expensive advertising. Do tell your story directly to an interested market. Do make it easy for people to share your content with others. Your challenge. I've written this audio program to drive you to action. As you listen and learn from dozens of people who have achieved amazing success, your challenge is to ignore the advice of your agencies and instead think about what you can do to trigger a worldwide rave of your own. We are the world. Obviously, ideas spread in many different ways long before we had the web as a tool to tell our stories. Before the web, ideas spread via word of mouth. The Midnight Ride of Paul Revere in April 1775 comes to mind, and via the mainstream media, television, radio, newspapers, and magazines. While this audio program is about spreading ideas online, it's worth looking at one offline worldwide rave from the era before today's tools were available. In 1985, in order to raise awareness of and encourage donations for famine relief efforts in Ethiopia, a supergroup comprising 37 of the best-known artists of the day came together to record a charity single. We Are the World was written by Michael Jackson and Lionel Richie and produced and conducted by Quincy Jones. The recording session took place on January 28, 1985, immediately following the American Music Awards ceremony that evening. The single was released several months later and reached number one on the U.S. Billboard Hot 100, remaining there for 4 weeks. It was the best-selling single in the U.S. that year, and it reached number one in other countries, including the U.K., Australia, Canada, and France. On April 5, 1985, a remarkable 8,000 radio stations around the world all played We Are the World at the same time. The worldwide rave created by the song generated many millions of dollars for United Support of Artists for Africa Foundation, USA for Africa, the charity created by the artists who donated their time and services to channel money to Africa. While We Are the World was clearly a worldwide rave, creating triggers for spreading ideas was much more difficult without the benefit of the web. To create a worldwide rave without the internet required USA for Africa to overcome immense difficulties, for example, wrangling the egos of dozens of the world's biggest pop stars. But you don't have Michael Jackson, Bruce Springsteen, and Stevie Wonder to help you spread your ideas. Thankfully, you don't need them. A dream come true. As some of you may know, when I begin a presentation, I always ask a series of four questions and have the audience members raise their hands to answer yes. Consider your own answers to these questions. In the past 2 months, either privately or professionally, in order to find an answer to a problem or research or buy a product, have you 1. Responded to a direct mail advertisement? 2. Used magazines, newspapers, TV, or radio? 3. Used Google or another search engine? 4. Emailed a friend, colleague, or family member, or used instant messaging, chat rooms or equivalent, and received as a response a URL, which you then clicked to visit the website. Apologies to those of you who have answered these questions already. Over the course of a year, in front of more than 20,000 people from dozens of groups all over the world, including such diverse groups as college students, marketing professionals, and executives at Fortune 500 companies, the answers are surprisingly consistent. Between 5 and 20% of people answer yes to the first two questions, which means the ways that so many companies try to reach people today, direct mail, advertising, mainstream media, are only effective in reaching a small portion of potential customers. However, between 80 and 100% raise their hands for the last two questions. Clearly providing great stuff on the web is critical for any business. Rather than trying to convince buyers to pay attention to your products and services by dreaming up messages and ad campaigns, offering great web content delivers interested people right to your company's virtual doorstep. This is a marketer's dream come true. Fear not. You too can create a worldwide rave. Okay, can I guess what you were thinking after reading about Cindy Gordon and the worldwide rave she created for the Wizarding World of Harry Potter? You might have muttered to yourself, if I had access to J.K. Rowling and I was launching the Wizarding World of Harry Potter, I'd be able to think of something cool to do online too. After all, there are millions of Harry Potter fans. Sound about right? And maybe you also thought, but I'm just a small business person. What can I do? Or maybe you're a business-to-business marketer, or a real estate agent, or the president of a university, or the singer in a rock band, or just about anyone. Fear not. The ideas in this audio program can help you reach your market, too. Your challenge. Consider what's interesting about you and your organization. Why do people like to do business with you? How are you unique? Those are the things that you'll leverage to tell your story directly online and trigger a worldwide rave. I'll introduce you to many people just like you who have created their own worldwide raves. Some, like Cindy Gordon, reached millions and millions of people. However, others have generated online interest in smaller yet no less important ways. I've looked at hundreds and hundreds of examples of how ideas spread and why people tell stories on the web. And in this audio program, I wanted to showcase examples that were as interesting and diverse as possible. Some organizations profiled here were already famous, but most were not. Some had marketing and promotional budgets at their disposal, but the majority just had some time and creativity to work with. Some were big, famous corporations, but others were small businesses, nonprofits, entrepreneurs, authors, and musicians. Here's a story of a woman who triggered a very different kind of worldwide rave. Girls Fight Back. Erin Weed, founder of Girls Fight Back, uses her website, blog, MySpace, and Facebook groups and YouTube videos as a way to promote women's safety and self-defense issues. We'd started Girls Fight Back in 2001 in response to the tragic murder of Shannon McNamara, her friend and Alpha Phi sorority sister. Girls Fight Back makes safety education accessible, especially to young women in their teens and 20s, through her education website and live seminars conducted all over the United States. She teaches girls and young women why they are their own best protectors and then shows them how to reduce the risk of violence and fight back if necessary. Everything we do is about spreading the idea that girls can fight back, Weed says. We need to give women the inspiration, confidence, and encouragement to fight back. If I had to choose, I'd say that confidence is the most important. So the community needs to come together to support giving women confidence. All of the information on the site is free and available to girls all over the world. While the content helps to sell the live seminars Weed conducts at nearly 100 colleges, high schools, corporations, and community groups each year, she is thrilled to be helping many more people than will ever see her live presentations. We get emails from people in places like Egypt who love the site because they have no ways to get the information in their own countries, she says. So even in the places where we don't run seminars, we help empower people. Weed is a big believer in using the web, especially for her task of trying to teach young women about safety and self-defense. There's a pretty huge stigma there that women who know this stuff are man-haters and not femme at all, she says. So we've been trying to make it cool to know how to stick up for yourself and fight back, which has been going very well. But I will say, the task would have been much more difficult without all the perks of the net. This is a topic that women want to be well-researched about before they take an actual class. People want to know from the comfort of their own homes. We're talking about women's worst nightmare here, so this topic is really important to get out there and make it available for anyone to access free, no matter where they are. Get out your mobile phones. Anywhere from 200 to 1,000 people attend each hour-and-a-half-long seminar. I'm always afraid that people will forget what they learned, Weed says. I want the girls to remember the seminar later, and I want their friends to know what they've done when they get home. Knowing her audience well has allowed Weed to create a terrific worldwide rave trigger, a technique she uses at each of her live events, but it requires a setup. When I'm ready to speak in an auditorium with 1,000 girls in the room, all 1,000 always have their phones on, she says. So, in the introduction, I have the organizers tell people to turn the phones off. A collective sigh and slumping of shoulders follows. Then, 90 minutes later, after a lively and fun interactive session at a high school or college, Weed asks the girls to take out their mobile phones. At the very end of my presentation, I have them videotape a 3-step self-defense series. They love it, and then they all post their homemade mobile phone videos all over the net, on Facebook and other places. It helps me to bond with the girls. They're like, wow, she's cool. She wants us to film. And everyone is filming, with maybe 10% ending up on the web. What better way to get them to remember what they learned than to put it onto the mobile phone and Facebook pages? They share it too, so other girls who weren't there will see it. Weed was also having a hard time getting the teen and college girls to log onto her website after speaking gigs, and paper sign-up forms to gather email addresses for 500 or more girls at a time was impractical. I realized we somehow had to get to them, as opposed to the other way around, she says. So instead, I get all the girls to...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.